This is a video on graphing functions of two variables using the CalcPlot 3D tool. So let's suppose I want to sketch the surface of z equals cosine of y minus sine of 2x. So what I do is I'm just going to erase this other surface, the default surface. It gives me lots of different choices. If I type in C for cosine, it'll focus on the ones that look like it. I could type in the whole function, but it's a lot easier to just find cosine of x minus sine of y and change that to a 2y. I could either hit the graph button or hit enter, and now it'll plot it. And there we have it. It's my beautiful function. I can zoom in and I can zoom out. There's a zoom in tool. There's a zoom out tool. Notice when I zoom out, I can really see the features of this function, and I can see the periodic properties of the cosine of x minus sine of 2y function. I can also restrict the domain to this function. So let's suppose I want y to only go from 0 to 4. I can go 0 for y, and I can go 4. Hit enter, and now I've restricted it. Let me put it back to negative 8 to 8. You could do the same thing for x, by the way. I can also change the number of grid lines from, say, 30 to 10. And the grid lines are the number of these curves, okay, these little sections, you'll see these little rectangles, and it's how the surface is sketched. So if I go 30 to 10, we'll see how that looks. Now we'll see it's much less smooth, but it kind of shows you what's going on. I can also change x and y independently by using a comma. So let's suppose I want 20 grid lines in x, and let's say 40 grid lines in y. If I hit enter, we have it. So you'll notice that y has more than x. There are other more advanced features that I can play with, but that's for other videos. For example, this one is drawing a contour plot. This one is the surface settings. We can also show the grid lines menu, and that changes all kinds of other things. And we can look at a trace plane on this surface. But that's another day. Finally, sometimes you don't want to function z in terms of x and y. Maybe we want to get a function, say, x in terms of y and z. One of the nice things that that will do is maybe we want to look to see what the intersection of a vertical plane is with this surface. So if I go to Add to Graph Select, and if I go to the bottom, I'll see function x equals f of yz. Let's suppose I want to see what is the intersection of x equals 2 with this surface. I can click that little box, and now I can see how the plane x equals 2 intersects this surface. I could do the same thing if I wanted to look at a plane, say, y equals f of xz, or a surface. And maybe I want to say, well, how does the surface y equals, how about 1 half z squared intersect this surface? I hit enter, and there's y equals 1 half z squared. I can say get rid of the plane if I want by clicking on that little check mark, and now the plane is gone, and I can just look at these two surfaces. The final thing I want to show you is sketching graphs of functions that are in cylindrical coordinates. So if I go to Select on Add to Graph, and I scroll down, I can see function r equals f of theta z. I click that, And now I can type in whatever function of theta and z I want. So let's say I want r equals, how about z minus theta? I type in z minus, and then I just spell out theta, T-H-E-T-A. I hit enter. And there it is. Let me get rid of the others so we can really see it. And there's r equals z minus theta. I can say zoom out. And maybe let theta, instead of going from 0 to 2 pi, how about 0 to 8 pi? There we are. And let's go to number of steps. Instead of 20, how about 80? And then we'll see it a lot smoother. And now we can really see how this graph works. If you go too many steps or too many grid lines, then the computer is going to work really hard to graph it, and it might be slow for you. But this CalcPlot3D does an amazing job in graphing surfaces that are functions of two variables. So thank you for watching this video.